guys, welcome back to my channel. I am just heading out to pick something up for the neighbor, and I thought since I was heading out, I texted Tasha and JR if they'd like anything. They want a fountain soda, so I'm gonna get that first and then come around. I thought about getting iced coffee, but I enjoy going to sleep between 10 and 10:30, and it's already 8. Well, I'd have 6 minutes to make it there. So, anyways, I did watch the live today. I was a little shocked because she said that she is going to make videos or lives, and she is going to keep them private and just send them to people that email her that, you know, I guess she'll share the link. So I'm thinking, I mean, you know, your videos right now get 2,000 views, which I don't know, I haven't looked, so I can't even say. If you're sharing them with somebody, maybe 50 to 100 people might email you to share the link. And if you're doing your channel to earn any type of income, then we both know 50 views is absolutely nothing. So I'm unsure of your motive there. I do understand that you constantly think, you know, people are beating you up or saying mean things. If you really listen, people aren't understanding your cancer journey. People don't understand about the medications that you state that you take. People don't understand about having boo-boos like that and never having such a bad infection where it landed you like in the hospital. These are the things that people have a problem with. So I'm not sure if that isn't being understood by yourself or not. However, you know, we all have our own thoughts and opinions, so doesn't really matter what other people think to you. So you do seem to change the things that you say or the things that you do. A lot of things are not consistent whatsoever. I think Lisa popped up in your chat and stated she was just watching, like, from behind the scenes. I just, you think people have been bullying Sally? Are you kidding me? People have been respecting Sally, treating her very well. Even letting her know, like, if she needed something, like, you know, for herself, like to get her hair done or maybe her nails or something, we could all pitch in and send money to a specific salon so she could get these treatments for herself. So if that's being mean and being bullied, wow, then what are you? You know, when James says we haven't been nice to him, well, you know what? When he was in the chat and he was on the live stream, I don't recall people being rude to you whatsoever. When you did that late night video, I believe you had your comments off. So what you were saying is what you were feeling and what you were thinking at that time. I mean, how it gets blamed on other people? Well, it gets blamed on other people because it starts with Jerry. She'll blame Jim or Sally, who in turn, Jim will blame every one of his subscribers. Like, I'd love to know the response to, you said an apology video to Mona. However, when you did apologize, you stated you apologized to Margarita. Now, I realize, you know, it slips our mind or whatever, but once you made that video and listened back to it, I don't know. You know, if someone were gifting me an RV, okay, and I didn't know the name of the person that was gifting it, or it just slipped my mind and then I didn't realize it. Or, you know, when Jerry Ann had some PayPals come in and then she couldn't remember where the money came from. She couldn't remember the people's names. Wow. It's simply amazing. Simply amazing. And I'd like to send my love and deepest prayers to Chatty Hag. When I was reading that in the chat about her son passing away, I was tearing up. And it's very sad. It's so, so hard and difficult to lose a child. It's one of the... It's the worst thing in life that I have ever, ever been through. And when I think that my life is getting tough, or if I think that, you know, I'm having a difficult moment being happy, I'll go back to that and think, you know, what happened today is not the worst thing in my life. And I know I can move on, you know, but it takes a while to get to that point. And very much my prayers are with you. I'm not sure if your name is Betty, but that's what you changed your name to. So please know that you're in my thoughts and prayers. Jerry Ann did jump to conclusions on that. And sometimes you have to listen to a person or wait to see what is going to be said before you cut everybody off. Questions were asked to Sally that she would start to answer and you would cut her off. You don't realize these things. And I do recognize that you're going to say, well, this is my channel. I'll do and say what I want on my channel. Well, totally understand that. However, when someone is speaking, you should let them have what they, a sentence or two, and then maybe say, excuse me, and then let that person get back to what they were saying. But let me run in here. All right. So, anyways, I just don't know how well that will do for your channel. The other thought that I had, you claim to be a teacher. I would just ask, you know, I get you don't want the live chat, like some of the, you know, not so nice names or not so nice comments. They could either A, be ignored or put in a timeout the whole live, so you don't have to worry about that. Or you could always do a live video with chat off and just allow comments after your video. There's so many different avenues to go, but you know, I'm just gonna say, can you imagine just responding alone to the 50 emails that you might get over the period of time? And you'd have to check that, what, at least every hour at the least, so you could keep your subscribers up to date on things. I mean, that's something to think about. So, are you gonna ever do anything on your main channel again? You know, people also want to know what doctor would say to take only 15 steps. Seriously, what doctor? What orthopedic, what primary would tell you only to take 15 steps? Mona, who is recently in physical therapy, actually did share, and I think I've said this, that her physical therapist, she asked about taking 15 steps. And the physical therapist has said no. They would either say unlimited, or, you know, 5,000, something like that. However, they wouldn't just say 15 steps. They would tell you not to walk at all. So this is where people think, you know, and these are people going to their own doctors who are actual physicians, just like I did with your boo-boos that you insist are not pressure wounds. Yet two doctors stated that they were pressure ulcers, which are bed sores. But you'll deny that till the end. You say that your rear end hurts, that you lost weight or something. Well, you could have lost muscle tone as well. Also, because your spine is either sitting in your chair or laying on your bed, since you're only allowed to take 15 steps. So do you not think that your butt is not hurting because your tailbone perhaps has a boo-boo on it as well? Why would you be a stage 4 cancer patient and not go to a doctor's appointment because you do not feel well? If I'm not feeling well, I usually make a doctor's appointment. Now, you have a doctor's appointment, even though it's with your oncologist, however you choose to cancel. So you choose to cancel for that. You choose to cancel for it's too hot outside, or it's too cold outside, or you don't feel well. Do you understand that when you do that, there's a patient that could have been seen, that needed to be seen, that was not because you had that appointment spot? I don't understand how you can cancel all these appointments, right? And your doctor still actually be your physician. Do you really have these appointments? Or do you just say you do and then say you cancel it? We have a lot of questions, and they have yet to, they're always unanswered. Why don't you do a Q&A video, write the questions down, and let people know, and be honest about it? You wonder why people don't think you're being honest and truthful. Something to think about.
All right, so I got the neighbor's cigars.
So anyways, I was saying about being truthful, and on your live where you became upset, I believe it's that live, I believe that you stated that your family doesn't even trust you. Well, then that pretty much speaks volumes. And you wonder why people have a difficult time believing what you say. I mean, it's no joke. The treatments that you are saying that you have for stage 4 cancer, something is not adding up. The fact that you are now, you know, on insulin, and you sit on your couch and you tell Jim that, you know, it's time for Oreo's nap, and that you have a honey bun on your bed that you were going to share to Oreo as a treat. First off, you're slowly killing your dog as well, okay? Is that Munchausen by proxy? I don't know. You're slowly killing yourself as well. Because, you know, I know you're going to use the excuse, well, I have the honey bun there in case my sugar goes low. However, you said it was for a treat for you and Oreo. So, And I'll let you know, when your sugar does go low, what you have is not a honey bun. What you have is 4 ounces of juice. You could have a teaspoon or a tablespoon of honey. You could also have the glucose tablets. You could eat a couple pieces of hard candy to rise your blood sugar. However, you choose to eat a honey bun. And, you know, you say, well, I don't understand. And, you know, like, your doctor stated to lose 150 pounds. You haven't followed those directions either. You were supposed to see a nutritionist. You know, and also, lately I've noticed you haven't brought up anything on your thyroid, which is, you know, a little odd. I mean, you were on the thyroid for a while, your mouth sores for a while, your boo-boos for a while, you know, your tumors that are running up and down your spine, and one that had fractured it, which had fractured it, you know, prior, what, over 2 years ago, which your back would have healed on its own, which could be why you were in that turtle shell so long. So, You showed proof right away of the mammogram. And when someone pointed out spelling errors in the paperwork that were shown, they were taken away very quickly. So they were, oh yeah, Jim had to delete that like lightning. You know, when you belittle people or when you rant and go off on people, just like you did with like your PPP loan, which is something that you should not have gotten. You were not making videos. You did not have employees. You did not have a large overhead. What are you talking about? You should have not gotten that PPP loan. You got that illegally by scamming the government. Like, but you want to know why people don't trust you or think you're lying? Well, I kind of think that's one of the reasons, sweetheart. So sometimes before you speak, you might want to think yourself and quit blaming other people for putting words in your mouth. Because these are things that you've said, and I have proven them, and I have showed them. I let them speak in my videos. You don't believe me? Go watch a couple. But until later, guys, no, I'll be back. Indeed.